they're giving you is goddamn human meat mixed up with soy and goddamn defiled, unkept animal meat, man. Whether you believe it or not, all right? So when that goes bad, guess what? No more food being brought in to America or other countries. Also, no more tractor trailer bakeries going across country delivering your groceries to grocery stores around the whole entire nation over here. So the famine is going to come about. That's one destruction. The other destruction was pestilence, disease, plague. It's going to be biological warfare, some natural, some man-made by Esau in these goddamn laboratories. He's going to release them in the public. You might just see a goddamn a short zombie apocalypse out here as well, too, man. Who knows? You know? Hey, you got the earthquakes, you got the famines, you got the plagues, the pestilence, you got the wars, the rumors of war. Those are the signs right there spoken about in 2nd Edge of the 9th chapter. Go back. Somebody say it's like chapter. Second verse.
Then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the Highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
The Most High is going to visit this world which he made. If you visit it, man, it ain't going to be friendly. And the Most High's not going to come down here. If the Most High was, infinite power, which is infinite, you know, this place will be just destroyed. What he's going to do is going to send his first begotten son, his first image to come into this world with the angels and this particular elect 144,000 men who are Lord willing, us brothers are your teachers, who are going to be given spiritual powers to ride with Yahweh Shai, the anointed Savior, when the Most High begins that visitation. Continue.
Therefore when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world.
That's right. And you have earthquakes going across the whole entire planet right now. You got the earthquake that hit Haiti in 2010. You got all these earthquakes that are ravishing throughout Latin America, Mexico, Central America, South America. There's a bunch of wicked Israelite Hispanic so-called Latino niggas out there. They are rebellious, they don't keep the Most High's laws, they commit adultery, homosexuality, lesbianism, prostitution, they believe in white Jesus and white God, all those idolatries, so the Most High is jacking them up. Okay, you got earthquakes in places where there shouldn't even be any earthquakes. You got earthquakes that are coming out here towards the south and out here in the central part of the U.S. now. You got an earthquake that hit New York a couple of years ago. It wasn't too bad, but it was just good enough where it was unusual. Okay? You got earthquakes that jack up all in the Pacific Ocean all times of the year. You got that earthquake that caused that tsunami in Japan in 2011. You got earthquakes that are constantly hitting over there in Asia. And they're going to continue to grow and grow and grow and grow and grow. Because the Most High is making it known, like, yeah, my spiritual anger is growing. It's sending a vibration down into your dimension. And it's fucking with y'all because that's what my anger is focused on. You wicked ass people upon the earth. Tiny insect ant-like people upon the earth that break my laws every single goddamn day, man. And some of the most worst transgressions that you can do, you people do, which is being homosexuals and lesbians. And talking about you a goddamn transgender, like that faggot Bruce Jenner, man. Alright? Y'all commit some of the most nastiest, utmost, worst abominations. So you goddamn right the earth is gonna earthquake, and it's gonna keep on growing towards 8 magnitudes, causing more tsunamis and more destruction. That's the anger of the Lord, because he's about to visit this bitch, man. Read on.
Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world.
There's uproars of the people. You got people that are rebelling against their governments. Because out there in Greece and a lot of those European countries, Greece, Italy, Spain, Portugal, and if you're in a country, they're having a terrible situation with their economy. They keep on shutting down the banks for weeks out there in Greece. I think they're cutting off the power and water in certain cities. So people are starting to go ahead and to get mad at their government. Because eventually what's going to happen, the economy is going to crash and all power and water is going to be shut off. It's not just going to be in here. That's going to be in America and other countries around the whole entire globe. The people are going to fight against their governments. So there's uproar to the people. A few years ago, you had Occupy Wall Street, and it grew into a occupy New York, occupy Las Vegas, occupy Phoenix, Arizona. Everybody was camping out in the downtowns of the cities, protesting the shit of how corrupt the American government is, and how you have the 1%, the elites, the Jewish elite bankers, and the other little set up Edomite little lieutenants and taskmasters that are not, they're non-Jewish, they're non-Amalekites, because they're not the real Jews, right? The so-called, the real Jews are the so-called Negro, Latinos, and Native Americans. And upon the confusion of faith, banner in here, where you have those Israelite Moors among the Southern Kingdom go and place their seeds at. Alright? But you basically had them protesting against them. And that's what they were doing, uproars of the people. You know? You got two girls, man? You're thinking about the words.
Then shalt thou well understand that the mess I spake of those things, from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning.
That's right, even from the beginning. In a time of Moses, it was already given to Moses when he was on the Mount Sinai, the understanding of the ending. I think you can read that inside the Apocrypha in Ecclesiastes. Or like the Ecclesiastes, I think it's Ecclesiastes, maybe second Ezra somewhere. I know it's in the Apocrypha. It was already understood that the end was going to come. In fact, in the time of Noah, it was given to Noah himself that the end was going to come, that there was going to be Yahweh Shah, the anointed. There's going to come out the nation of Israel through his line of his son's Shem. That was known in this time. That's why you had these other nations that have different variations of Christ within their religions. Within the Egyptians, they had their own version of Christ. Within the East Indians and their belief in Hinduism, they had their own version of Christ. The Babylonians had their own version of Christ. Because it was well known that Christ was going to come. Via Noah, he gave information down to his sons. This information was given from the beginning of time, man. But all which was about to unfold was currently unfolded at its last marks of prophecy today as we speak. As you watch this video on YouTube. Read on.
For like as all that is made in the world hath a beginning and an end, and in the end is manifest.
The end is manifest. You can tell me at the end. The society is at its most worst it has ever been, man. Homosexuals everywhere, lesbians everywhere, pussy whip men that bow down to women everywhere, men pushing baby carriages and all that, you know? Men wearing those little straps with the baby was on a harness strapped to their chest at the one goofy-ass movie and shit. I think with Jack Black and one of those comedians. You got basically a bunch of puss man giants in the society that bow down to the woman and do whatever the woman tells them to do. They kiss ass to the woman. But it really should be the other way around. Women were made for men, not men for women. And that's in Corinthians. That's in the Bible. That's in the laws of the Holy Scriptures. That was well known in the Old Testament. There's not needed to be given a law that women are to be subjected beneath men. It was already understood, man. It was said to hell in Genesis, the 3rd chapter, verse 16. I'm not going to get it real quick, huh? Because we don't know by now that men are above women, mentally and physically. The 3rd chapter, verse 16. That men are above women, both mentally and physically. Alright? You understand why America is so messed up. You have a bunch of effeminate men that are raised by their mothers, are raised with an effeminate, soft-ass vibration about themselves. They even go to us, brothers, too, before we came into the truth. We had that mothers and women vibration on us because we didn't know any better. We were conditioned by this goddamn world about what Esau put in the media and the goddamn cartoons. Especially that goddamn Disney, man. Teaching that Disney princess brainwashing syndrome. The kiss woman ass, every woman is a princess, and you must treat her delicately. You must put her on the pedestal, high and mighty above you. That's weakness, man. A woman is beneath you. Read on. So follow and read it.
This is Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband.
Yeah, you gotta say, she said, oh my God. You got them right. What the scripture just say? You got them right. Alright? The word God means power, damn means to be condemned. I mean, you are goddamn right. God has condemned you. Oh my God, you don't agree with it. What the scripture just say? It just condemned you. It said the woman shall be subjected to her husband. You know why?
because the male is the dominant. The male is the superior. The female is the subordinate. The female is the submissive. Why do you think the male has his fleshly scepter, all right, and the female has her fleshly deposit? The man sticks his rod inside her cavity. What does a man get out of it? A man gets pleasure. What does a female get out of it? She gets both pleasure and pain. You know why? Because she's the subordinate. She's the submissive. If you are a ruler and a dominant over somebody and they're your slave, how do you put them in check? You chastise them. You whip them. You beat them into submission. Hell, that's how you conquer nations, by war. So therefore, right there, when it comes to man and the woman, the Most High naturally made the woman to be subjected to the man. But not here in America, though. In America, ain't nothing but a society full of homosexuals and goddamn lesbians, full of pussy-ass men, mangina. Say who? What'd you say? You said something?
First five books to get the gist of the moral laws, the
dietary law is in Leviticus 11 chapter in another book in the first five books. The Leviticus 11 chapter tells you what you can eat and what you can't eat. And it forbids pork, swine. It forbids fish that obtain fish and scales, which wipes out all shellfish. And for you country cornbread motherfuckers, man, and goddamn catfish. No more catfish, Kool-Aid, and cornbread for y'all. Alright? You can eat cornbread, I wouldn't drink no damn Kool-Aid. That's just nothing but dye and sugar and fluoride, right? But no catfish though, because catfish don't contain fish and scales. We got a dietary law to upkeep, okay? You begin keeping the laws with the dietary law and every other law is one too. Don't be a homosexual, don't be a lesbian, don't commit adultery, don't look at another man's woman, don't put tattoos, don't put marks, aka tattoos, upon your flesh. We putting piercings in your damn earplugs and gadgets and all that, man. Don't be piercing your nipples to you sluts out there, you freaky sluts. You know about that shit nowadays. And that's a new epidemic. These girls putting piercings on their genitalia and their little secret parts and their little nipples, their little nips and their little vaginas and all that. You ain't got fucking weirdos that put piercings in their balls and all that. What is wrong with you people in this room, man? You and the water lord's going to destroy y'all. Y'all sick in the head. That's